Welcome to this video of Daily Current Affairs. Today I'm doing episode 217 with you and the date is 24th of February 2019. Subscribe to our channels Pinnacle and Frontier IAS. If you have not done so far, click on the subscribe button or click on the bell icon. These are our websites sscclpinnacle.com and belgidhaka.com. You can visit them. Now let us discuss the two questions that were asked in yesterday's quiz. The question was, Reserve Bank of India has recently warned against the download of which app as it may cause phone data theft. Question number one answer here is going to be AnyDesk. Next question, who has been appointed as the first ombudsman of the BCCI by the Supreme Court? Answer is DK Jain. Let's move on to the first question. Which country recently submitted a formal bid to host 2032 Olympic Games? This is question number one. Answer here is Indonesia. Indonesia has submitted a bid to host the Olympic Games to be held in the year 2032. Okay. Why have they done this? Because recently last year when Asian Games were held in Indonesia, the whole world praised it. So they think that they could even host the 2032 Olympic Games. Now they could face competition because even India wants to stake a claim on these games. And there could be a joint bid by North and South Korea as well. Indonesia's ambassador to Switzerland, he submitted a letter from the President Joko Widodo to the International Olympic Committee. Now among the Asian countries, it is Japan, China and South Korea. Japan is going to host the Olympic Games in the year 2020. Then you know very well that South Korea had hosted the games in the year 1988 and the games were even held in China in the year 2008. Okay, so that was question number one. Now let's see where exactly is Indonesia with reference to India. See, this is India. If you look towards the southeastern side, you are going to find this country known as Indonesia. Okay, this is Indonesia. Now here, the capital and largest city. What is the capital and largest city? It is Jakarta. Here you can see in the map. Official national language is Indonesian. It's a unitary presidential constitutional republic and president is Joko Widodo. Vice president is Yusuf Kala and currency is Indonesian rupiah. That's the currency. Let me show you a picture. Here you can see the picture. These are the five Olympic rings. Now let me take you to the second question. The Words in the Garden festival on Gandhian philosophy, this is being held in which of the following cities? This is question number two. Answer here is going to be New Delhi. Question number two, my answer is A, New Delhi. The Words in the Garden festival on Gandhian philosophy, it is being held in New Delhi. And the festival named Words in the Garden will host noted people from the field of literature, art, social sciences and many others. So answer here is going to be New Delhi. Okay, earlier events explored themes like Mir Ki Delhi and Galib Ki Delhi. This is question number two. Here is a picture related to this. Let's move on to the next question. The UP state government, they have decided to observe Adolescent Girls Day on which date of every month at Anganwadi centers across the state? This is question number three. Answer here is going to be the 8th of every month. The UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, he launched a scheme for adolescent girls. Okay. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, he launched the scheme for adolescent girls who are between the age 11 years to 14 years and who have left their education, and he will take steps to provide them proper nutrition and special care. UP government has decided to observe 8th of every month as Adolescents Day at Anganwadi centers across the state. So question number 3, that's the answer, 8th of every month. Here is a picture related to the question. Next, question number 4. Recently, Union Minister of State Sadhvi Niranjan Jyoti inaugurated first mega food park of which state? This is question number 4. Answer here will be Tripura. Tripura is going to be the right answer over here. Question number 4 answer is B. Recently, Tripura got its first mega food park, which was inaugurated. It was named Sikaria Mega Food Park Private Limited. It is located at village Tulakona in Agartala and it has been set up in 50 acres of land at the cost of 87.46 crores and the government of India has approved a financial assistance of rupees 50 crore. Now let me also do a revision question with you. If you have been following my videos, then the Ministry of Food Processing, they had also commissioned the first operationalized Godavari Mega Aqua Food Park in Andhra Pradesh for fish and marine products. So that was question number 4. Let's see a picture related to this. See here, you can see Tripura Mega Food Park. Let me show you where exactly is Tripura located in the map. This small state which is located here is Tripura. Capital is Agartala with 8 districts. Governor here is Kaptan Singh Solanki. Chief Minister is Biplab Kumar Deb. Legislature is unicameral with 60 seats. Lok Sabha has 2 seats and Rajya Sabha has 1. This is additional information. Cloud Leopard National Park and Rajbari National Park are important national parks from the state of Tripura. Here you can see the small state is Tripura. The state has a very, very high literacy rate. Okay. Now let's move on to the next question. Which country presented Asia's first same-sex marriage bill? This is question number 5. Answer here is going to be Taiwan. People of the same sex, they can get married now. And which country has presented this bill? This bill has been presented in Taiwan. The proposed law gives the same-sex couples similar legal protection for marriage as heterosexuals. Okay. The new bill has also been met with criticism from conservative groups that have opposed this. Okay. Now let me show you where exactly is Taiwan in a map. Now here you see this is India. If you take a look with reference to India, when you look this side here, this island that you see, this is Taiwan. Okay, this is Taiwan. What is the capital? Capital is Taipei. Okay, what is the capital? Capital is Taipei. Taipei is as well the largest city also. Okay, it's the largest city as well. National language here is Mandarin de facto. Government unitary semi-presidential constitutional republic and president is Tsai Ing-wen. Premier here is Su Sang Chang and currency here is the new Taiwan dollar. Okay, so that's the information about this currency. Let's move on. Next question is here. Next question asks you, who became the first Indian woman to receive Future of Nature Award? Who is the first Indian woman to receive this award? That's the question. Okay. Now, question number 6. My answer here is going to be Divya Karnad. Okay. Divya Karnad, she is 33 years of age, 33-year-old Ashoka University teacher and Wipro Sustainable Fellow. Divya Karnad has become the first Indian woman to be honored with the Global Future of Nature Award and she has done a lot of work on marine conservation. Okay. Yeah, Karnad. Okay. Now about this award, it is a prestigious international award that celebrates achievements in protecting wild animals and plant species. Now let me show you a picture of Divya Karnad. Here is a picture of Divya Karnad. Next question. Recently, Home Ministry ordered Pan India survey to assess impact of which of the following services? This is question number 7. Okay. Question number 7. My answer here is going to be police services. The Ministry of Home Affairs, they have commissioned the Bureau of Police Research and Development to conduct a Pan India survey called All India Citizens Survey of Police Services. This survey will be conducted through the National Council of Applied Economic Research, New Delhi, and the aim is to understand public perceptions about police, gauge the level of non-reporting of crimes, etc. And the survey will commence next month. It will cover a representative sample of about 1.2 lakh households and it is spread over 173 districts across the country. So let's take a look at a picture related to this question. Here you can see Citizens Survey of Police Service. Next question. Next question asks you, the Union Cabinet approved construction of which rail-based high-speed regional transit corridor of RRTS covering a distance of 82.15 kilometers. This is question number 8. For question number 8, my answer here is going to be the Delhi-Ghaziabad-Meerut. Okay, Delhi-Ghaziabad-Meerut is going to be covered. Now, the Union Cabinet has approved construction of Delhi-Ghaziabad-Meerut corridor of regional rapid transit system. It will cover a distance of 82.15 kilometers, and this is the first of its kind rail-based high-speed regional transit system to be implemented in India. Once it becomes operational, it will be the fastest, most comfortable and safest mode of commuting in the national capital region. Okay, so that's the information about this question. Let's take a look at the picture. Here is your picture. Next question. Indus Water Treaty, which is in news these days, it was signed in which year between India and Pakistan? Answer here, it is going to be year was 1960 is the year. In response to Pulwama terror attacks, the center has decided to stop India's share of water that used to flow to Pakistan, and the government's decision will not impact Pakistan's share of water under the Indus Water Treaty between the two nations. Okay. Now, the sharing of water of the six rivers, that is Indus, Chenab, Jhelum, Bias, Ravi and Satluj, between India and Pakistan is governed by the treaty which was signed between the two countries in the year 1960. Now, let me just revise with you some more questions that we had done related to Pakistan. The first one was that the most favored nation, okay, the most favored nation status which was given to Pakistan was withdrawn. The firstly. Secondly, the industrialists and the traders of Agra, they have decided that they are not going to buy any leather from Pakistan after the Pulwama attacks. So that was question number 9. Here you can take a look at a picture of this. See, here you can see this is the Indian Punjab. This is the Indus River. It is known as the Sindhu in Hindi. Okay, here it flows. Indus flows only through the state of J&K in India. These are the other tributaries. So Indus, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias and Satluj, these are the five rivers. Here you can see the Indus Water Treaty. It was signed in September 1960. On April 1st, 1948, India stopped the supply of water to Pakistan from every canal flowing from India to Pakistan. Pakistan had protested and India finally agreed on an interim agreement and on May 4th, 1948. This agreement was not a permanent solution. Therefore, Pakistan approached the World Bank in 1952. Finally, in Ayub Khan's regime, that an agreement was signed between India and Pakistan in September 1960. Next question. We are on question number 10 now. Indian personality. Which Indian personality has been elected as the new vice president of the Asian Hockey Federation? This is question number 10. AHF. Okay. Now here, what is going to be my answer? Answer will be Mohammad Mushtaq Ahmed. Mohammad Mushtaq Ahmed. Question number 10. My answer will be C. Okay. Mohammad Mushtaq Ahmed from India has been elected as the new vice president of the Asian Hockey Federation for a 4-year term at the AHF Congress in Gifu, Japan. Besides him, Ms. Ashima Ali has been elected unopposed as one of the executive board member of the AHF. Okay. Now, let me show you a picture related to this. Here you can see the picture. And now let me take you to the keywords. 2032 Olympic Games. Indonesia has proposed that they would like to host it. Words in the Garden Festival is being held in New Delhi. Uttar Pradesh will hold a day for adolescents girls on the 8th of every month. First mega food park of Tripura has been set up. Asia's first same-sex marriage bill has come up in Taiwan. It has been proposed in Taiwan. Future of Nature Award has been won by Divya Karnad. For police services, a survey is going to be done. RRTS, Rapid Road Transit System, is going to be launched in Delhi, Ghaziabad, Meerut, that is the NCR. Indus Water Treaty was signed in 1960. Asia Hockey Federation, okay. Here the question is, the Asia Hockey Federation over there, Mr. Mohammad Ahmed, okay, Mr. Mohammad Ahmed, he is the Indian who has been elected as the new vice president of Asian Hockey Federation. So that was all about the keywords. Now quiz for the day. Quiz for the day. First question, Indus Water Treaty, which is in news these days, it was signed in which year between India and Pakistan? Who became the first Indian woman to receive Future of Nature Award? These are our two questions. I want you to answer them. If you have liked the video, give it a thumbs up. Do share the video and subscribe the channels. All the best. Bye-bye.